So today we'll see what is web elements and locators. Okay, so we'll go one by one. Okay, so first we'll try to understand what is, you know, web elements. Then we'll see basic of HTML, then locators, then we'll see what is web elements, what is locators, why we should use locators, and when we should use what locators. Okay, that means when we should go for which locator. So first we'll try to understand what is web element. Okay, so let me go for a real-time example. So I'll just give you one Facebook example. Okay, so here is a Facebook web page. Okay, so I'll just inspect it. I'll just go right click mouse, then I'll be having this option called inspect. I'll just click inspect. Once I click inspect, so I'll be able to see these elements. So these elements are where? On the web. So that is called simple is web elements. Okay, so this web element, this is whatever you are able to see, these elements are, you know, web elements. Okay, these are actually HTML, like HTML page, or actually you can say that DOM, document object model. Okay, so I'll just click here inspect. Okay, I'm using as of now Chrome, you can also try in the Chrome. So I'll just use here inspect. Okay, I'll just take my mouse cursor to this login button. Okay, once I'll take my mouse cursor to this login button, so what I can see is how this login button has been designed internally by using HTML. So that I can see here, right? So here I can see, you know, input HTML tag, value is equal to login, arial label is equal to login, then data test ID is equal to royal login button, type is equal to submit, and ID is equal to something, right? So these are the attributes, okay, key and value pair. These are the attributes which we have used to design this login page, right? As per your comfortability, you can use anything. So we'll see this part basically. So this designing this login in the web page, that HTML, you know, input will be like this. It will look like this as of now, you understand. Okay, so basic definition of web element, you can say that whatever you can see in a web page, in any web page, any website, so that will be called as a web elements. Like email or phone, this is also one web elements. This text field is also one web element. This link is also one web elements. This login button is also one web element. So any way, any place, if you click, and you will get the web element. See, so everything, whatever you can see in a web page, will be known as a web elements, right? Yes, so go for next. So before going for the locators, we need to understand the basic of, you know, HTML. Okay, so we'll try to understand the basic HTML. So basically we'll try to create our own HTML page, our own HTML page, and we'll try to do some stuffs there only. Okay, so that it will be very, very easy to understand you. Okay, so see, I have created one basic HTML page. You can also create. How you have to create, I'll just tell you quickly. So anyhow, once I'll inspect, same thing, right click inspect. Okay, what you have to do is you have to create one notepad. You have to create one notepad. As of now I'm using Mac, so I can't show you as of now. So you can create one notepad txt file. Okay, then inside txt file you can start with, you know, angle braces HTML. Okay, open close. Okay, this is HTML tag actually. Then again head, and head you can give anything, whatever you want. Okay, anything, whatever you want. Okay, if you want give head, you can give, or else it's not mandatory. Okay, then body, again in body you can give anything. So as of now I have given two things. Okay, username, then I've given tag input, type is equal to text. Okay, again I have given another HTML tag input, type is equal to password, and again I have given another HTML tag a, then href is equal to this. Okay, now you have, you might you know, need to understand what is this a, what is this input, what is this type. Okay, what this password mean, what this text mean, right? So all the basic web page will be designed using three things. Only three things will be there in a web page. Okay, basically we'll see what and all things are there. Three things. Okay, so basically three things will be there. So we'll see what and all. So we have three things, that is HTML tag, attribute, and text. Okay, what is tag, what is attribute, and you know, what is text. So we'll see now this in real-time example. So here I just inspected. So if you'll see, so anything which is there in, you know, between this angle braces open and close, okay, directly, like if you'll see here, so this is like this. Okay, angle braces open, this is angle braces close, in between some text is there. Okay, So this will be known as text simple. So whatever you will write here, this will be the text appears in your web page. So see here I have given, so click here to log in. So this will be visible because I have made it as a text. If I'll remove this whatever you are able to see, this link will be not there with this text, okay? But link is there, but this text will be not there. So where user, how user will get to know, okay, there is some text and which is associated with some link, okay? So this is how, this is all that part of, you know, UI developer, or you can say that, you know, front-end developer, right? To create a web page, interactive web page, lots of things will be there, okay? So no need to go in deep. So we'll understand here basic thing, okay? So basically in a web page, so suppose as of now I have created one web page. So here are how many things? So here I have username field, here a password field, and here one I have given one link, sample link, okay? So click here to log into Facebook, okay? So what I have given, so here if you see, so this head, HTML, head, meta, head, you know, head open, head close, again body open, then body I have closed here, okay? So like in Java, how we used to, you know, open class and close class, open method, then close method, like that. Here in HTML also, if you are opening in body, that body should be in, okay, with this slash, forward slash, right? So like that. So here three things will be there. What I know? So HTML tag, okay, then attribute, then text. Three things. So what is here, you know, tag? Tag is your, you know, this one, HTML, head, meta, okay, body. Then input. So it will start with the angle braces. It will start with angle braces. Whatever will be there in the start with angle braces, that will be HTML tag in a web page for that particular web page. Okay, so for username, this is the HTML tag input. Okay, for password, what is the HTML tag? So input. So for this link, what is the HTML tag? So A. So all the links will represent with tag called A. And link, whatever I'm going to associate, that will be href always. So href is equal to, if you'll give something, that will be link, okay? This is a basic thing. So I can give this link, how uniquely I can identify this link is, I can give ID, I can give name, I can give the class, or I can give the text, okay? So text I have given here, right? So if you'll see, I have given this text. So these are the three things. So what and all? So input HTML tag. So it will start with single, open braces, angle braces, right? So this is input, okay? This is again, A is what? HTML tag. And href is equal to what? Some link. ID is equal to FB. Name is equal to Facebook. Class is equal to FB login. These are the attributes. So attribute will be always there in the form of key and value pair. So ID is equal to FB. Name is equal to Facebook. Class is equal to FB login. So these are, you know, attributes. These are called as attribute. So key and respective value, okay? So first we see HTML tag, then we have seen attributes. So attribute, multiple attributes will be there, belongs to for one, you know, web element. So if you'll see, I'll click this link. So how many attributes are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4 attributes, okay? href is equal to this, id is equal to this, name is equal to this, class is equal to this. Okay, then this is another, you know, text I have given for this link. Okay, so input HTML tag we have seen, attribute we have seen, then text. So text will be always between, you know, angle, open angle braces and close angle braces. So whatever will be there in like this, in close and open angle braces, it will be known as, you know, text. And this text only will be visible to the user, not this ID, name and class and link text, right? So this text, if you'll see here, it is able to visible, right? So this is just a dummy page which I have created, okay? So you can also create it the same. Just what you need to do is, I'm giving you simple steps. Open a notepad or txt file, create one txt file, okay? Notepad, give html, okay? Then give body. In body you can give anything, okay? Whatever you want to see, okay? So see, this is open angle braces, here it is closed. So this will be definitely one text, so which I am able to see here, username, right? Here again it is text, so here I am able to see the text, okay? So now this is input HTML tag. This is HTML tag, which is what? Input. This is HTML tag, which is what? A, right? This is also HTML tag. This is what? Body, right? So we'll see only this part, okay? Input, then we have A, HTML tag, and these are the attribute, okay? So if you'll see about the username, so we have this username associated with what? This type is equal to text. So attribute is only one, and input tag is what? Input tag is what? Tag name is what? Input, right? So you just create like this. Okay, HTML open, HTML open. So nothing is just I have kept in one angle braces HTML, then HTML close. Okay, done. Now give a body open, then body close. Okay, then you can give username like how I have given here, double quote. Then give input type is equal to text. Again give password, input HTML tag for password. I'm giving input type is equal to password. Then you can again create, you know, a, then href is equal to some link, whatever link you want to display here. Okay, so if I click here, it will navigate to this text, will navigate to where? https://facebook.com, right? So for that you can give whatever you want. You can give your own unique, you know, id, class name and name. Perfect. So just try it out in notepad.txt file. Just create a dummy notepad. Okay, write html, give body, this head not required. Okay, give html. Okay, give body. In body you can give, you know, username, and just open and close braces, give input space, type is equal to text, mandatory. Okay, small. Then again give password, then give input type is equal to password. Okay, so password if you can give here also, if you give here, so this will come this side, that's all, no difference. So just try this, creating this dummy, you know, page, and you'll understand the basic. Okay, and once you created this page, the save that file as .html, not .txt. okay, you open a txt, write all those things, go to option, okay, go to file and save as html.html. once you save as a .html, you'll get like this. So give some name and save with .html. okay, .html. So if you see html, since I'm using Mac, so I'm not able to reproduce that scenario as of now, but it is very simple. Just go and try to create. Okay, it's very simple. So once you'll create, and then it will create a separate, you know, page like this, look, locator demo1.html. okay, like this it will create. Once you click double click on this, so it will, you know, open like this, it will populate like this. Cool, hope this will be helpful. Just try it out. Okay, see you in the next.